I don't think I've really ever thought of it as a job. It's just something I've had to do.
Yeah, I think we're all making sacrifices to be here. Sacrifices for the Dotterels. So, yeah, hopefully it pays off.
The first time I saw a Southern New Zealand Dotterel, I was 14 years old. I got the opportunity to helicopter up to Mount Rakiura with a family friend. I got to spend the whole day searching for Dotterels. There were birds everywhere. Whereas now, there's less than 126 remaining. In October, November 2022, the Department of Conservation formed the Southern New Zealand Dotterel recovery team with four permanent staff. Over the years, I've been fortunate enough to volunteer and help out with the Dotterel team, and now in a permanent role. I'm Daniel Cocker. I'm a ranger on the Southern New Zealand Dotterel recovery team, based on Rakiura, Stewart Island. Currently, we're on the hilltops of Ka Puke Turoto, the mountains of the Tin Range. This is historically an important breeding site for the birds. The Southern New Zealand Dotterel is probably the rarest bird you've never heard of. At this time of year, I'd describe it as a tomato with wings. They're dark brick red colour at the moment in their breeding plumage. Southern New Zealand Dotterels are a true native birds of New Zealand. They've still got that really friendly, innocent manner. They breed up on the mountaintops of Rakiura. They used to be found throughout the South Island. However, they were wiped out. Feral cats are widespread on Rakiura. They can kill not only adults, but also chicks and eggs. And a few years ago, some dock rangers got video footage of white-tailed deer eating dotterel eggs. So we need to be out there as much as we can and protect the birds.
I think my favourite thing about being a ranger is probably seeing positive outcomes when you put in a lot of work. You've been trapping hard and yeah, just doing everything you can to try and make like one nesting attempt successful. My name's Guy, I lead the Southern New Zealand Dotterel team here in Rakiura, and we're here at Table Hill today to undertake cat control.
Big cat.
So these are feral cats. They have no connection with people at all. They just live in the forest, eat forest animals. These cats are like the biggest pests to all native species on the island, really. I actually do have a soft spot for cats. I had a family cat growing up, so I do respect them, but I also see the damage they can do when they're not looked after and they're not in a house. So our goal here is to try and bring the Dotterel's population back to a healthy, sustainable number of birds. It's going to come down to really a few things like the funding, staff capability and effective control methods of cats. So with our project we've got about 15 kilometres of track network and we've around about 100 traps set currently and we have to maintain it ourselves. I really enjoy the challenge actually, the challenge of trying to look after an endangered species. But there's still like large areas of the breeding sites that we don't have any traps because we just can't afford it and don't really have the manpower to service those traps. Sometimes people reckon that it's a good idea to put a whole fence around the mountaintops. I think the conditions here are so windy that I think the fence will just get flattened in no time. And also it would be pretty hard work trying to maintain the fence.
Yeah.
I wanted to have you up here because there's literally a story to tell. So, like, we literally were trapping up here, but it's still not enough. It's still not
enough. A New Zealand dotterel should live to be 20 to 30, even more, years old, but on average, as Southern New Zealand dotterels will not live to be more than 4 to 5 years old as a result of feral cat predation. It's one of the tougher parts of the job is seeing birds that you know well and you're really familiar with, and yeah, seeing them disappear each year is really tough. One of the birds I'd quite often see up on the hilltops was a really friendly bird. I'd actually named that bird after my girlfriend. I remember that bird approached me and I was just lying down on the ground and just hanging out with it. It was really cool. And I remember, you know, saying to that bird, "I'll do anything it takes to save you guys." Following trip up onto the hill, found that bird had been killed by a feral cat.
Maybe if we just all have a search just sort of around this, like sort of 20 meter sort of area just around here.
Yep.
Just because I really want to see if we can find a band or anything. Sucks. It really sucks.
Yeah, it was really gutting to find that bird.
Yeah, it's definitely pretty hard on the team morale when we find dotterels that have died, especially ones that we've seen before, we've seen the nest, we've handled them. It's pretty heartbreaking finding their little bodies and finding their bands. Pretty big challenge when you're looking after a species that's and so close to extinction. It's pretty hard on the old mental health. I try and just, try and be a bit silly and make nice food and... Oh, I'm not too sure. Just do random things, they like some stuff, so it can sort of take our mind off things a little bit.
Yeah, we've got two Southern New Zealand dotterels here. Two Southern New Zealand dotterels. The birds are very friendly.
On our way.
Cool. I just saw it as an opportunity to make a change, try and bring this species back to a healthy population. Our numerical goal is to have 300 birds by the year 2035. So that would be an increase of about 20 to 25 birds a year. So we're currently at 125 birds. So yeah, it's ambitious. But if we can get all the predators under control, then it is achievable, I think.
We are the last stand in saving these birds from extinction. And so we've just got to keep going, no matter what.
We just want to make sure the dotterels are safe. We're trying to reduce the numbers of cats as well as we can.
Future generations will criticise how we've responded to this situation, just as we criticise situations in the past. Quite often when I've been reading extinct bird books, I'm thinking, why did people not act sooner? They could have been saved, there's so many opportunities. That's what the future generations will ask of us. And so it's really important for us to do everything we can to, prevent the extinction crisis. There is hope, but we need to act now.
Thank you.